So how do we create an online course that actually works for your audience? Stay tuned. I'm going to share this with you in this episode. So there are a lot of courses out there, but not all of them work. You could be creating an online course or product where, hey, it's just a flop. It just doesn't work for the audience. You see, selling an online course is actually not as difficult as getting your product or service, or your online course in this case, to actually work for your customer. That's actually the more difficult part. So how do we get there? How do we mastermind these things to making it work and function and getting our clients the success that they need, that they deserve, and taking them from the start to the end? Well, I'm gonna show you in this video how we plan all these things out. So as we go into it and we look at a kind of our mastermind plan here, what you can see is if we're creating kind of a product here, and that's what we're gonna be looking at, is if I go in and start creating a blogging course where they can make money and make their first dollar from a blog. So let's say this is my course, make your first dollar from a blog. Okay, I have to plan out from the start to the end what the process is going to be, and I have to take them on that journey through my course. Now, this is just a hypothetical example, just to give you an idea of how this may all work and pan out. But you're looking at, okay, so if they're starting over here and we want to end up getting them to their first dollar, there's some action steps that have to be taken for them to get there. So what do we need to do? Well, first, they might need to create a master plan. And then they might need to go in and do a niche research or choose a niche. Then they'll have to build a website. We'll have to get some traffic to that website. They'll have to build a product. We'll look at offers and sales pages, and then advertise and collaborate and get more traffic to those sales pages, tweak and refine and that kind of thing. So this is kind of our cycle and process that we might have to go through. So this is how we're looking at building out our course. So we might have multiple modules, okay, under the master plan. How do we do it? How do we think about it? How do we research it? Then about the same thing within the niche, the same thing within building the website. How do you want to structure it? How do you make sure it's not too salesy? How do you do it so that way people have an easy time to do a purchase, to a checkout? Thinking about all these processes. What platform do you go with? The same thing with traffic. Where do you get your traffic? How do you bring in the traffic? How long? Things to expect. And then how do you get your products? So this is all about building out. You know, you're not looking at just a blogging course. This is really a business, because this is what they're doing. They're building a business here. And that's what we're doing. We're trying to get them from this step. So this is our first step, all the way to the end, okay? And then you might have offers and sales pages, and then advertisers and collaboration and so on. So these are all the sections and modules, but in between that, you might have some things in here where it's like, okay, well, this is all stuff that's getting started, the prep work. So you might have some content here for the prep work. And then as well, once they make their first dollar, how do you accelerate and grow this even further? So that could be, again, more things in the future. So as you're looking to build out this course and this content that actually works for people, you have to take them on that journey. How do you get them to take the action steps? Is it kind of like a 30-day program? Can they do it in 30 days? Maybe it'll take longer. Maybe it's like a 60 to 90-day program, because by the time they get their website up and running, it's like, man, it takes time. So like day one, you might need to go in and, you know, get the hosting. Day two, get the website, research who you want the to build the website. Day three, choose your template. Day four, you know, build out the logo while you're doing this. So that could be a step-by-step process. So depending on how you format this, you just want to take people from step one to the end. Some people are better on a day-to-day basis, kind of on a routine. Other people, man, they want to get all that knowledge and information and just go for it. So you'll have to kind of measure your audience and how you want to structure that course to see what makes sense for you. And then that's kind of what you're trying to do, to build a course that actually, you know, sells, that actually also works for your audience. Because otherwise, what you could do is you could create and come up with a course, but it doesn't necessarily work for your audience. Because selling the course part of, hey, how do you make your first dollar from blogging, or make your first dollar online, or make your first dollar from your YouTube channel, that part is not difficult. The selling part is not as difficult as actually getting people to do the work to making their first dollar, because that's all that stuff is out of your control. You got to get them to take that action steps. And the only way you can do that is by influencing them on either motivating, taking them a step-by-step process and making that process as easy as possible or as detailed as possible. So anyways, plan this out. And as you're planning this out, work your way backwards. So, okay, from the first dollar versus where they're at, maybe they're not technical savvy. You might need to give some prep work for a basic like computer knowledge course. Like, what is a sales page? What is a lead page? How do I advertise? What places can I advertise? So again, depending on how basic you want to get into it. Now, once you've got this set up, you know, on your online course, what you can do is go in and dig deeper into each one of these sections. So if you want to promote this, what you'll do is you'll go ahead and say, hey, this is how you get traffic. So those people that already have a website, they may be interested in traffic. So as you're doing your opt-in, your freebie, your advertising to sell this course to your audience, you take any one of these components, okay, and then push into it kind of a freebie, an offer, and so forth. But that's really what you're looking for, is you start kind of from that end and go back to the beginning, working out the different components and then looking into, hey, what are the little subsections that I need in order to make this viable? Because getting them to actually do the work and getting people successful in that area, going from step one to the end, is way more difficult than most people imagine. Because otherwise, you know, the selling part, people will buy courses, they'll buy products and informational goods, but they just never pick up the book. They never pick up and take the action. And that's the more difficult part. So anyways, this is how you do it to make sure that it's a step-by-step process for them, as easy as possible for them. And then you're more likely to succeed within your own course and product that you're selling. And then if you have other products that you're selling and offering, they're more likely to purchase those products in the future from you as well, as they continue to expand and grow their business. Anyways, thanks for joining me. Hope you enjoyed some of the other videos that we have available. And if you haven't seen them, check them out on our YouTube channel or our website at backstageincome.com. And don't forget, there's a lot of great freebies on the website as well.